Thank you, Father. Thank you, the Son. Thank you for the light shone on your word daily. Except you shine your light on me, no one can comprehend it. We receive help from you. You will continue to help us even this evening. It causes us to understand more of it. It causes it to mix up with faith in us. It causes it to bring forth truth. Most importantly, to prepare us for your second coming. The vision of the four beasts in Delhi.
Ati denu le ni yejo ipe dande diri ran o ti ri ran kejo ba babeli o to wo so yana ni sha ju ori kanun we dande di koda odun mene la o to di pe Babeli bo si owo awon ile afasia dande di ran.
As in reference to background, we discover that this vision has come to play 40 years before the fall of Babylon to the hand of Media and Persia.
So it's about to be to me a group of
so the turbulent sea.
See, I get to be the two more in a man.
We saw that the turbulent sea is a metaphor or a symbol of the troubled world from where four kingdoms presenting the beast will emerge.
At the moment, you know, I don't go marrying you, don't want to cast you out of the world.
You see three out of the four beasts read to us last week and their implications.
It's a lamp and a very white dad and the other one will be a one.
You that are not privileged to hear it can ask for the record from the publication department. The first one was like a lion. And he can also fly, has wings. We saw that lion representing the kingdom of Babylon, that is Nebuchadnezzar, with his flying wings with which he has sway over the world. We saw beer as being a cannibal, a devourer and sucker of blood. We saw him that one side is longer or dense than the other one. We saw the integration of two kingdoms with one being subsumed by another one. The Persian government prevailed upon that of Media. We saw three ribs in his mouth representing the conquered nations that he conquered immediately.
leopard.
He saw the fourth one, leopard. He had four wings. He rules and overrules swiftly across the globe. But suddenly, the wing was winged. We look fully into that in chapter 8, representing the Grecian government. Look at the fourth one today to some point. Introduction. That is chapter 7 combined with chapter 9 played a very vital role or central in the book of Daniel. That what this chapter 7 and 9 of Daniel are to the book of Daniel could be likened to the importance of Romans chapter 8 to the entire book of Romans. Similarly, the chapter 53 of Isaiah, as vital as it is to the entire book of Isaiah, could be likened to the importance of this chapter 7 and 9 of Daniel to the book of Daniel.
That these
references are very vital and important because they have to do with the prophecies concerning the coming of the Messiah. So these chapter 7 and 9 have very great implication about the coming of the Messiah. And all these references are also considered by the Lord Jesus Christ himself, whether directly or indirectly referred to in his earthly ministry. So this chapter 7 and 9 of Daniel were very vital to the point that even Jesus, whether directly or in any way to them, or even the apostles also, made a technical reference to them. To convince
you,
but what we are looking at is very vital in the history of mankind, particularly with cognizance with the coming and the reign of the Lord Jesus on earth.
Esai 26.
Our next version will be in Daniel chapter 7-8. Then we skip to verse 19 to 21 and finally to verse 23 to 26.
Lẹ́yìn èyí, mo ní nínú òru sì kíyèsí ẹranko kan tí ó burú jù tí ó sì lẹ́rù tí ó sì lágbára gidigidi. Ó ti gbé ẹ̀rínlá, ó ń jẹ, ó sì ń fọ́ túútú, ó sì fi ẹsẹ̀ rẹ̀ tẹ ìyókù mọ́lẹ̀.
After this, I saw in the night visions, and behold, a fourth beast, the Roman Empire, terrible, powerful, and dreadful, and exceedingly strong. And it had great iron teeth. It devoured and crushed and trampled what was left with its feet. And it was different from all the beasts that came before it. And it had 10 horns, symbolizing 10 kings.
19.
Mo sì kíyèsí àwọn ìwo náà sì wo. Ìwo kékeré mìíràn kan sì jáde láàrin wọn. Níwájú èyí tí a fa mẹ́ta tu nínú àwọn ìwo ìsájú. Sì kíyèsí. Ojú gẹ́gẹ́ bí ojú ènìyàn wà lára ìwo yìí àti ẹnu tí ń sọ ohun ńláńlá.
I considered the horns, and behold, there came up among them another horn, a little one, before which three of the first horns were plucked up from the roots. And behold, in this horn were eyes, like the eyes of a man, and a mouth speaking great things.
Nígbà náà ni mo sì ń fẹ́ ìmọ̀ òtítọ́ ti ẹranko kẹrin, èyí tí ó yàtọ̀ sí gbogbo àwọn ìyókù, tí ó lẹ́rù gidigidi, èyí tí eyín rẹ̀ jẹ́ irin, tí èékánná rẹ̀ jẹ́ idẹ, tí ń jẹ, tí ń fọ́ túútú, tó sì ń fi ẹsẹ̀ tẹ ìyókù mọ́lẹ̀.
Ẹ̀kọ́ èdè yẹn o, eyín rẹ̀ jẹ́, èékánná rẹ̀ jẹ́,
idẹ,
iṣẹ́ ìránṣẹ́ ẹ̀ ni, fi ẹsẹ̀ tẹ.
Then I wish to know the truth about the fourth beast, which was different from all the others, exceedingly terrible and shocking, whose teeth were of iron and its nails of bronze, which devoured, broke, and crushed, and trampled what was left with his feet.
Tí ó yàtọ̀ sí gbogbo ìjọba mìíràn yóò pa gbogbo ayé rẹ́, yóò sì tẹ̀ mọ́lẹ̀, yóò sì fọ́ túútú.
Thus the angel said, the fourth beast shall be a fourth kingdom on earth, which shall be different from all other kingdoms, and shall devour the whole earth, tread it down, and break it in pieces, and crush it.
Àti ìwo mẹ́wàá láti inú ìjọba náà wá ni ọba mẹ́wàá yóò dìde. Òmíràn kan yóò sì dìde lẹ́yìn wọn, wọn ó sì yàtọ̀ sí gbogbo àwọn tí ìsájú, wọn ó sì borí ọba mẹ́ta.
And as for the 10 horns, out of this kingdom 10 kings shall arise, and another shall arise after them, and it shall be different from the former ones, and it shall subdue and put down 3 kings.
Wọn ó sì máa sọ̀rọ̀ ńlá sí ọ̀gá ògo. Yóò sì dá àwọn ènìyàn mímọ́ ti ọ̀gá ògbó lágara. Yóò sì rò láti yí àkókò àti òfin padà. A ó sì fi wọ́n lé lọ́wọ́ ti fi di ìgbà àkókò kan àti àwọn àkókò àti ìdajì àkókò.
And he shall speak words against the Most High God, and shall wear out the saints of the Most High, and think to change the time of sacred feasts and holy days and the law. And the saint shall be given into his hand for a time, two times, and half a time, 3.5 years.
Ṣùgbọ́n àwọn onídàájọ́ yóò jókòó, wọ́n sì gba agbára ìjọba rẹ̀ lọ́wọ́ rẹ̀ láti fi ṣòfò àti láti parun dé òpin.
But the judgment shall be set by the court of the Most High, and they shall take away his dominion to consume it, gradually and to destroy it suddenly in the end.
Eshe je ka bere bere lo wa ra wa ya ma kan ma ka lo guru eran ko kerin yi won lo leru gan kini kan to fe ya to luju ala yen si awon eran ko yoku.
The fourth beast is declared fearful, very fearful. What do you think differentiates that beast from the previous
one?
What type of set of teeth does it have?
Yes. E kana wo lo wa ni owo re.
The day.
Se. Ki lo nfe yin yen e se. Owo mi.
With what? Another person please. With what did he do? With the teeth. Another person.
Ki le yin fe yin se.
What do you use your teeth to do?
Ada ki lo nfe yin se nigba na. Eh? Kuri ire le yin e.
Because the set of teeth is iron. There is nothing it cannot break. Devoid, break it and devoid.
Ti kini yen o ba fe se je, ti o ba se fe se mu. E kan wo lo wa lo lowo re.
And the nail in how many horns? A youth.
Whether
made of nail. How many horns does it have? How many horns on the head? Womewa. Ten horns on the head. I say, didn't get everything
up.
How many horns are in the head? We have 10 horns plus a little one, making up 11. Supposing you are the one that dreamt. Won't you be afraid?
So problem.
Daniel was somehow startled because of the description of that beast. That intentionally want to get the interpretation of the fourth beast. And for the nail and the iron teeth and the little horns. What's the difference between the little horn and the previous 10? Raise up your hands. What's the difference between the little horn and the first 10?
Though
very small. But what's the difference?
Oh yeah,
raise up your hands because we've read the Bible. If we don't get the trace down of that very document, we might not get the understanding. My mom offer. That the little horn has the eye. Like human being.
Eh?
That he has a mouth.
Horn
has eyes and has mouth to speak great things.
Oh, then sorrow.
Was speaking great things. What was the performance of that little horn? He performed a certain act there. Okay. Out of the 10 first horns, there is no way you will dream such kind of dream without being afraid. Even the following morning, on your way to your place of work, you will not be. Even when, while taking your breakfast, you will not be totally all right. Even after the interpretation,
Daniel was not the same.
So it affected the life of Daniel in one way or the other.
So that was now banker.
So if we read it, it should bring a difference into our lives. I said it last week. All the documents in chapter 7 of Daniel. He said that this vision of Daniel in chapter 7 here is similar to the dream of Nebuchadnezzar, who became king, dominate the whole world. If you didn't forget, you know why we were looking into chapter 2 of Daniel. He said that the golden head represents the kingdom of Babylon, which was actually far better than every succeeding kingdom. So we have declining administration. From gold, the lesser one should be silver. Remember, in the rulership of the golden head, which was Nebuchadnezzar, he happened to be a minister of God, as God referred to him. Because he did what God intended him for. To harbor the Jews for 70 years in captivity. And to dominate the entire universe then. In fact, even God determined to compensate him for how he handled the Egyptians as God wanted. He was the best government, then. The one that seconded it, that is the Media Persia government. That kingdom was good also because he has reference for God, the fulfillment of God's prophecy on Israel, by commanding the Jews to go down and providing them materials for the erection of Jerusalem.
The next
government was also good because he ruled the entire universe and had dominion over it, by even to the extent of introducing Greek as a universal language then. And the language was still in use, even till the death of Jesus. Although his kingdom had been overthrown, somebody emerged under that government that was very great in the whole world, called Alexander the Great. But he was suddenly broken and dethroned. We'll look into it later. The New Testament from Matthew, except Revelation and John's epistle. Every other one were written in Greek. Written in Greek language. The kingdom that be, it has two legs, which marks a partition between the eastern and western. This fourth beast has a iron teeth. It was the last government that was very great all over the world. It's still mixing up with the whole world. When it was winning, iron mixed up with earth, with soil, then 10 toes will emerge there. There's a mixture of iron and clay. The kingdom is peculiar.
Republican government. O yato ninu agbara, o yato ninu ise, o yato ninu iwa, o yato ninu ise.
Is different in conquest, is different in administration, different in all its entirety, not only just in policy.
Awon asa re ati ise re.
Tradition.
O yipo mo gbogbo aye patapata do ni olori.
Is tradition and culture mixed up with the entire world today. Most of the administrative hints today in the whole world came from Roman Empire. You go to academics, they overhauled education, they overhauled politics. We even have political philosophers, philosophers who are very great on earth. The kingdom still have the mix of cannot diminish absolutely till it
collapses.
At the tail end of the administration, 10 horns or 10 kingdoms will emerge out of the Roman Empire. We interpreted it to mean 10 kingdoms. It was an angel that interpreted it to Daniel.
And
Now that in the midst of the rulership of the ten kingdoms, a small horn, probably not actually noticeable, will emerge and will be speaking great things. He will overturn the programs of the world. He will fight against three and silence them. And the others, the remaining seven, will do no other thing than to surrender their administration to that little horn. He will continually speak blasphemies against the Most High God. He will wage war against the saints of the Most High God. But eventually he is going to be broken without a hand. But the judgment will be set against it, the Most High will see it, and suddenly a stone without hands will smite that very peace and the kingdom, while the entire rulership will be handed over to the saints of the Most High God. Daniel chapter 7 verse 7. Compare it with verse 23.
After this, I saw in the night visions, and behold, a fourth beast, the Roman Empire, terrible, powerful, dreadful, and exceedingly strong, and it had great iron teeth. It devoured and crushed and trampled what was left with his feet. And it was different from the beast, from all the beasts that came before it. And it had ten horns, symbolizing ten kings. Then the angel said, the fourth beast shall be a fourth kingdom on earth, which shall be different from all other kingdoms, and shall devour the whole earth. Tread it down and break it in pieces and crush it.
So, I repair one intact
when Daniel saw this revelation or vision, the kingdom, it has not all totally been fulfilled, but there is a gradual fulfillment to this point we are now. After the collapse of Babylon, Media Persia took over the government. After the collapse of Media Persia government, the Grecian government assumed office. And after the splitting of the Grecian government, the Romans took over. Romans broadly split into two and started his rulership in 146 before Christ. In the east, they ruled.
In the west.
In the east, they ruled until 1453. If you go into European history, you will come across them. Everything about the Roman Empire, you meet it there. You go to the encyclopedia, you will see it there. Confirming the prophecies of the scriptures. If anybody is twisting the Bible, he's doing that to at the detriment of Islam. It was evident that Israel went to captivity. It was also clearly evident that Israel is torn from Babylon. Remember that war is still going on the land of Israel today. You shouldn't forget that Jesus told them that they will be recaptivated again, second time. And he said they will be gradually restored, but not totally until he comes to put final restoration to peace.
So my in 1948, Israeli won pada de gege bi orilede won igba koko
that Israel
said igba ti won ti wo ti Rome ti wo won mole ni AD 70 the Rome conquered Jerusalem won wo temple.
You should not forget that after the Second World War 1948, Israel started getting back to their land after the collapse of Israel Jerusalem in the 70 years after the death of Christ, AD 70.
Jesus there so po kuta kan ni du olori ekeji the temple at when about am Matthew
Jesus has said that no single stone will remain on another as far as the temple of Solomon is concerned.
People say ban yin soro yi,
as I am talking to you,
mosque nla kan lo wa lori ibi ti temple Solomon wa.
There is a great mosque at the spot where the temple of Solomon was originally. There is a problem now that the two religions should be accommodated on the same spot. Israel is preparing to build their temple at that spot without rival. The two religions, Judaism and the Muslims, they are striving over that spot. They believe strongly that those who are buried there are likely going to be the first to rise during the resurrection. So they want to rise. So the Jews have a part where they bury their corpse. If there's any spot that could foment trouble or generate a strife in the whole world, is that very spot where the Temple of Solomon was. It's because God has not concluded with the Gentile. He's still willing so. Probably to still accommodate more converts from the Gentiles. That was why Benjamin Netanyahu stepped down from the government.
Samaria in the Bible, Samaria one, Samaria first bank. Only come up with the first bank, only not the facility, only Samaria.
Even the first bank, he has restored the original name to Samaria. That they continue to erect buildings there.
Only Jerusalem, the president and eternal capital Yeraye, Israel, capital Yeraye.
You say Jerusalem is the eternal capital of Israel. A believer hearing all this news without giving it a thought, if he's not mindful of the second coming of Jesus, I think the person is playing with his eternity. As we are here,
won reti Messiah to nbo wa joba to ba gba won lowo gbogbo awon ijoba monarchy to wa laye ti Jerusalem a je capital won ka won fowo lo loju won se ma ma gbe won fe gbalẹ won bi ton ma ma fe taku ton ma ma padu nipa ti Messiah ma joko lori aga dafu yen na won reti lowo lowo
Israel
won ma de be won se reti eje kan lo ma de tori a oni kan mo gbo sumo wa ati kan te wa mo gbo abi be ko ati kan o ti jinde lati ko wa lo.
The people of Israel are expecting their Messiah, who will practically come as a ruler over Israel, to liberate them absolutely from the fangs of the Gentile nations. They never expected, they never believed that their Messiah died, but that the living Messiah will descend from heaven to rule.
Won ni kankan se pelu Matthew Mark Luke Johan apostle Paul to them were to se to kan won to kan won kini Isaiah wi Jeremiah wi kini Daniel wi kini Zechariah wi bo se fowo lo kini Musa wi kini Moses wi bo se fowo lo ri.
They are actually strongly knitted with the prophecies of the Old Testament, like Jeremiah, like Isaiah, or Moses, and every other one, and not so much interested in what is done in the New Testament. But we have better privileges. We've seen the fulfillment of the suffering of Jesus Christ. Saw how he manifested his glory in our lives as a church. And those the people tagged as the saints, we saw how Jesus, after his resurrection, took them to heaven. Don't forget that God has been, I've been mindful of the Gentiles. Even before the death of Christ, the integration of the Gentiles into the families of God has started. But particularly when Jesus rose from the dead, it was widespread all over the world to bring non-Jews into God's kingdom. The church is the benefit or outcome of Christ's death. Because he went to his own people, they disregarded him. He took the church as his harvest or profit gained from the world and hand over to God.
Baba Moses saw the odu ikore, o saw the iba ikore. Ti gbogbo ene muse, gbogbo e lo ni muse mo ti fi se ko daadaa.
Like even the feast of harvest enshrined in the law of Moses, all these have the accomplishment fulfilled in the Bible, and I've explained them fully to you. That is why it pains us when some people, after claiming to be born again, for them to still go back to those physical feasts which had been fulfilled in Christ Jesus, like the Passover and the unleavened bread, that's the first feast. There is no need of adoring a particular day more than the other, Feast of New Moon, or new day or holy day and so on. All these are services in the flesh that will perish with the world.
Akoko ajo ire koja ni won kan Jesu mo.
Jesus was crucified during the celebration of the Passover. So he ate the Passover before he was killed. Remember, the Jews, the priests, did not enter into the auditorium or the court of law or the court, because they don't want to be defied so as to eat of the Lord's Supper. Jesus is our Paschal Lamb. That day, their program for the Passover was distorted because the veil of the temple got torn from the top to the bottom. Impliedly, that day Jesus technically cancelled the celebration of the Passover. And if anybody goes back to resuscitate it, is worshipping idol. 3 days after the Passover, the high priest will bring the first fruit.
He
go and weave it. And wave it.
We
take two cakes with little yeast and he bring the first fruits. The first one is without yeast, only one. That was the third day that Jesus rose as the first fruit. And he raised up the saints that were there to go and present them to God as a sample of his fruits in the world. 50 days after that,
Fifty days
after the first fruit was before God, then the Pentecost will happen. That is two cakes of bread with leaven. It stands for the beginning of harvest. Right from that day, God has entered into harvest program. God inaugurated the harvest, universal harvest, that day by winning 3,000 souls to the camp of Jesus. While Jesus was on earth, he said we should continually pray that God should send laborers into his vineyard. The world is ripe for harvest. He's sending us. After harvesting for him, then we will be stopped by the sound of trumpet. After Pentecost, then you have the feast of trumpet. You see them in Leviticus 23. There are two trumpet sounds, the one to gather them for solemn assembly and the other one for war. The one with which the saints will be gathered together before God. And the trumpet that will gather the whole world to Armageddon, play war ground. After the feast of trumpet, then there will be the feast of atonement. The church has gone. would have gone with the Lord Jesus. Then there will be the Feast of Tabernacles. And Jesus and the saints will come down as rulers in the kingdom of Christ. We are all under the administration of beasts.
We
want to depend on the government of beasts. We see leopards. They will drink blood, trample upon
but
all the worldly administrations are
All the worldly governments
are under the fourth beastie government. They are under the fourth beastie government. Their ministry is to eat and devour, consume. Is there any difference between one political party and another? No difference. Their program is to eat and devour, and the one that remains, they will trample upon it and waste it. You want to get anything from the government? If you mix up with them, they might consume you. They consume one another. Iron with iron teeth. And the finger is brassy. The whole universe. One might be better than the other. But their ministry is to devour. The American government is collapsing gradually. Things are collapsing.
Particularly the Democratic government, which is number debe. Okay.
They are there to cause everything to crumble.
Human rights.
They claim to go for human rights. When we have homosexual, things are not getting better. It is a worsening administration. Barack Obama waged war against all nations that are against homosexual.
Tori pe won pass e pe kosile kosike Nigeria.
Why Good Luck was deprived the second chance was because he went against homosexual.
Oya e ma se ju lo everybody oraye lati se koda won fe se policy won se ma
They are about to pass a policy that where the fetus will be extracted from a woman for medical attention, for medical treatment, for remove the fetus and process it into drugs to cure certain diseases. Fourth kingdom.
Okay. you are free to have animal as your girlfriend.
What of the law? Where a law, particular law, is endorsed to marry beasts, human being, marrying animals? People are now getting married to beasts. You are free to marry beasts. In the Western world, they delight very strongly in taking care of beasts, like dogs. Can embrace and kiss dogs and other pets. Having intercourse with dogs. Is this actually getting better with that? We get to economy. Just for everybody to be converted to animals. I will not be treated to animals. That's why we say you should accept the Lord Jesus. That the world is mixing up fast. Things are getting increasingly difficult.
It's human manipulation to make us peace.
The issue of corona, they say, is human manipulations to unify the whole world, possibly. Whether you believe it or not, everything got into play in a laboratory in the People's Republic of China. And the whole thing was blown into the world. Now you are being forced to get injected. They thought that Africans would be eliminated, but God is allowed it. This is the time of salvation. God has made us special. We have very strong immunity. The number of casualties in the United States and even in the United Kingdom. I read the researches to that effect. They've come to conclude that drugs will work. I'm following it up wisely to the Bible that Jesus is about to come. Our redemption of the body is at hand. Roman kingdom. It will produce 10 horns when it is at the diminishing point. 10 kingdoms, 10 kingdoms
will. It is in Europe.
The 10 kingdoms will emerge from the old Roman Empire, basically United Kingdom.
I will bother you to make you to know that Roman Empire at the four yele yele one day you could have one job for.
There is a reunification now of the Roman Empire.
And we will get like what I told you, German force image.
Germany got broken into two.
And one Aquac and Europe, but Soviet, you know.
Some part went with Soviet Union.
German gone west, you know, east, you know, east, but Soviet, you know.
So Eastern Germany went that with USSR. But from the time that Berlin Wall got broken, that one that was ignorant of that wouldn't have known that Germany was once split into two. So you know when our president was addressing the international world about the Germany, he was living in the past. That Germany was T2 instead of unified Germany.
Bulgaria, Poland, all of them, Kumonuwa Labe, former Roman Empire, Kumonuwa Labe, liberated Patakota, Czechoslovakia, Eripe, Soviet, come for.
Remember the Soviet Union got split into four republics.
Europe, to one Labe, one Jade, Soviet, come for Yede.
The Soviet Union got broken into four republics. What is God looking for? Salvation. God is looking for salvation.
Ukraine to understand to everybody, church is a power to be reckoned with in Ukraine. You need to do that. Or can we go against? For can we go no church? Tell it. So long. Ebala.
Formerly, you know, USSR happened to be a communist country where they paid no due respect for God nor human. But when it got split, the gospel was able to penetrate there to the point that souls are being won, big churches, even countries of the world. And precisely Nigerian ministers are there having a very notable congregation. God told us to pray that He wants to deliver the Palestinians.
We
want to work out salvation among the Palestinians.
Naturally,
we like Israel. But you say you want to save among them. When we went to Israel, we discovered factually that God is
a Palestinian believer.
That God was working out salvation there. One of those who piloted us happened to be a Palestinian believer. Israel might still be rebellious because God still have the Gentiles in mind. And this is the time of the Gentile, harvest. The increasing hardship in this country, don't be surprised that God is behind it to win souls. God is winning souls, and there is no barrier to God's penetration.
In Africa, God is moving, and God will still move.
Ni orile de Africa, Olorun o di ade tun ma rin si.
Sheri, mo se kokan lojo Sunday, mi mo ti ma pari e. Mo so pe God will give you bountiful harvest wherever you are.
No, Olorun a so yin de gogo, a so yin de ni ibokun to ga.
Awon wa kan lo, mo ti lo. O na fe bi ki won yo.
Some of our children are going. Don't spoil your children. Let them be saved. Let them be saved. And let us equip them. You don't know where God will send them.
Some of them that are anointed,
God knows those who are anointed among them. They will arise. If you hand them over to the world, for them to come back and do what God wants them to do, it might be very difficult.
I told you the other day, but Musoro, once you go and one more palace, you papi, once you send me a bunch.
When the royal princes were taken to Babylon, look at how God's righteousness was established in the foreign land.
all most nations of the world are going to the west. And going to the west, believers are penetrating into them, moving into them. And one more one, I want to know. Come out of the southern way, and put the call. Come out, and they will shine.
There are people are flocking and getting flocks into the west. And most our children, those who are vision, who are missionaries, they are there also, and they will outshine.
Technology, that is not God's. God has something greater in mind. Olorun ni kan to le koko lokan lori eto gbala enikeni o le leta duro.
Salvation is prime in the heart of God concerning the world program.
How did the lotan koko wa ko lo ma lotan nigba ta ma sele koda ogoro le ma soju ta ma ri awon omo yen to ma turu to Olorun ba so. There will be a great move of God, a great move.
Olorun no wa gbara jade agbara to ma gbe eyan ori ogan na be gba te eyan rin lori ile.
So, there
is a brain drain, you know, Nigeria migrating to other nations. Don't worry, anywhere they get to, God will make use of them. But if they are mature and strong, let them be strong and mature. They are mature. There is no way the plan of God will not be fulfilled. It will come to pass. The beast with 10 horns.
The
10 horns that will come from the old Romans. 10 toes. From what that very division of that man in Daniel chapter 2. Remember, a stone without hands from on high will crush the entire image.
Till
this moment, the 10th kingdom is yet to be obvious from the old Roman Empire. It is prophetic, it is of the future.
Let's look at
Revelation 17. Revelation.
Yes.
Ori meje ni, oke nla meje ni.
Ben.
Lori eyi ti obirin na joko. Oba meje si ni won.
Oba melo ni oke meje yen. Oke meje yen to obirin agbere joko le. A ma so yin baba debe o. Ori meje, kina ni itumo ori meje yen.
Oba meje.
Oke meje. Oke meje yen wa je oba melo.
Oba melo
e ma ka
awon marun subu
ni akoko ti Johannu nko we yen.
By the time John was writing, out of the 7 kingdoms, 5 have passed.
Okan be
akoko ti won ko we yen.
By the time he was writing,
oba kan lo nse akoso aye.
There was a king ruling the world then.
Ituma meje yen awon Oba meje to se akoso Israeli ninu itan na.
The 10 king, the 7 kingdoms are basically referring to kingdoms that took Israel captive or rule over Israel.
Ele to se ijoba ni kefa.
It was the one ruling that was the 6th one.
Ni kefa yen ni Rome.
And that 6th one was Roman Empire when John was writing. Number one that ruled Israel,
Egypt,
was Egypt.
Assyria.
Number one, Assyria. Number two,
Babylon.
Number three, Babylon. Number four,
Media and Persia.
Number five,
Greek.
Number six that was ruling when John saw this vision was Roman. But the seventh one is yet to come. The Roman Empire will still emerge. That Roman Empire that we rose will be Roman. And the eighth one will emerge from the seventh one.
Okan yoku ko si de nigba ti o ba si de
bene
yo duro fun igba kukuru
akoko le o le pe
era ko ti o si ti wa ti ko si si o na si ni ekejo o si ti nu awon meje na wa
seri o ti nu awon meje ike eran ko yen to ma si akoso ti an soro re yi gugu agbara Egypt. Asha Egypt,
all the power of Egypt, Egypt and the culture of Egypt and the Portic powers of Babylon and Greek, all over everything annexed together. We now rule the eighth one. The seven will surrender all their power to the eighth one.
Am I gbagbe bi awon gbogbo nkan ti bi joba awon yen ti nwo ni agbara won nwo nu ara won lo asa won nwo nu tigbati Egypt kuro Assyria ti Assyria kuro ti Babel kuro gbogbo to wa nu Babel lo wonu Media Persia gbati Media Persia kuro gbogbo to wa nbe lo wonu Greek gbati Greek kuro gbogbo to wa nbe lo wonu Rome se ti gbo be yen gbati na ko na ba ma de.
There is a streaming of power and influence.
Thank you very much.
Of all the kingdoms from the head flowing down till it gets to the toe.
O si lo si iparun.
Ben.
Iwo mewa ti iwo ri si ni ijoba mewa.
E ma gbo bi ti mo lo lade. Iwo
mewa ti iwo ri ni. Ijoba mewa ni won
e ma da mi lohun ijoba melo
ti won ko ti gba ijoba
mo fe lo nbe lo kan won o ti gba ijoba nigba ti jo anu powe
these ten horns or ten kingdoms
won de ti gba ijoba
they have not received administration and even till now they've not emerged.
Mo fe buri yen won o ti gba ijoba
they have not received administration
be se ri mo mewa ni bi le ma di ninu iwe fi han ori iketala to soro nipa eran ko yen gan so oba mewa yi o ti igba ijoba di akoko yi ijoba won o ti di o nbo
these ten have not received their administration or kingdom till now but later they will emerge.
Ṣùgbọ́n wọ́n gba ọlá bí ọba pẹ̀lú ẹranko náà fún wákàtí kan.
Ìgbà tí ìwo kékeré bá máa ṣèjọba.
When the little horn, they will rule together with the little horn. The little horn, which is the eight kings, will rule over the seven and the whole world. They will have the same constitution. They have the same convention.
Once if you are bad at your life, one for a conan,
one for your life,
they will surrender their power and their honor to the little horn. They will surrender everything to the little horn.
I want one, you need yours in my bow, dragon, to jagon.
They will war against the
land.
They will crash at Armageddon.
Shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Shout hallelujah. Shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
The woke kere.
The little on.
Jackanye. Say, Kejo at the Kesson Daniel in
chapter 7.
One new comment, Yak, when it be.
There are other names, versions given to it.
Yak, when it be.
In the Bible.
Daniel Rickerson.
For instance, in Daniel chapter 9,
verse 26-27. O my lady, tombe,
the prince that shall come.
Yes.
Ben.
The people of the prince.
You come.
I come in my father's name. You receive me not. Somebody will come in his own name. Him shall ye receive. The people of a prince.
And after the 62 weeks of years, shall the anointed one be cut off or killed?
It will Jesus in him. Yes.
And shall have nothing, no one belonging to or defending him.
Yes.
And the people of the other prince, who will come with his
the
presence?
The people of the prince, the man of the people, in your malade come.
It's going to be people, a person that is endorsed by people.
Ori Kechi.
2 Thessalonians chapter 2.
He
called him a name.
He
calls him the man of sin.
He
called him the son of perdition.
Yes. Have your Korean share. Yes.
And it told you, you feel me and all that part.
Ben.
See, you see, if you know, we were a soldier, son.
Ben.
And you, and you were a young, you can be said, Satan.
If you don't mind, and it's a in your man, laddie, Una, your Korean share. Una, your man, pound.
He is the called the man of sin, the son of perdition. And the wicked one. The world is preparing for it now. There will be nothing like sin. There will be nothing like sin. Sin will become righteousness. There will be nothing like sin. Abortion will not be a sin. Drug addiction, will not be a sin.
Everybody is free.
All the kingdom trying to declare human rights in a very terrible and stinking way. They are instrumental in the hand of the devil. Since I was born in this country, the account of rape in the current Nigeria is quite disturbing. It was noted for in India, but Nigeria, eventually all these activities will no more be seen. Rape. I read a paper. The girl was walking along the street half naked. The madman went to embrace her. You can't wear half naked dress without being raped. What happens in university campuses? It never happened when we were in the university.
weekend
every weekend they will be sweeping out used condom on the floor everywhere.
It's
so terrible that children are no more living on campus. You know that is got to a point that most of the students they live in the same room in the off campus. You don't monitor your children. They would have married so many years ago, living as husband and wife. That the off-campus hostels, we have a mixture of male and female. That very seductive and
tempting.
So the so-called human right has technically eroded virtue and moral upbringing. You parents, I'll keep on telling you, what do you want your children to be? As you are here, wearing abnormal dress,
send
our the order that they should be sending those children with abnormal dress home. They have been war. They should send them, and some of them will even attempt to come and be ministering to us in song.
I want to produce.
They should go.
Joshua, gbogbo eran to ba Joshua ko woni lo sin Olorun. Eran to tele gbogbo lo sin Olorun.
All the generations and
Joshua,
one or two subsequent ones, they worship God. Two of them go to the land of Canaan. They worship God. He was after that such generations that children started misbehaving. Our generation is still here, and I named many of them. I christened them here. You might go and support them to for wedding outside, but God will fight against you. If you re-indoctrinate them to drive them away into the world, to re-indoctrinate them against this God standard, God will not take it easy from you. If you want to do it, go and do it alone. My own daughter, all of you were witnesses. I drove her away. I drove her away. Before the absorption, I first of all drove her away. I never followed her. He said he was traveling in the hospital. I said she would die. My became chastised. And I want her to be chastised. And she was chastised. She returned and shouted that all the places where she has gone, that her way had been blocked. You are to come to Jesus, that's why I'm weeping. Continue to lay all the church members away. God will fight against you. If you encourage them to go away, you keep on technically encouraging them to go into the world. Some are still mourning their living children. If you are actually there, you won't allow your children to wander away, because the world is getting mad every day. We are not, if your children derail, you shouldn't follow them. That's what we are saying. Remain firm. He sent a child for university career in the UNAD. She became pregnant. The man was insisted that he never.
But at the same time,
you should be firm in Christ so that your child will come back to God. There is spirit of error. The spirit is everywhere following them. You are the one to restore them. You try to be firm. Don't follow them. They will eventually come. May you not regret at the end of your journey. Well, let him go and do the marriage. If you indoctrinate any of whether your own biological children or other people, God will not take it easy from you. All of you here, we met here. It is the Bible that unified us. This lecture I'm producing unites every one of us. Whether you are family member, that's not number one. If anybody goes against that Bible, if you don't want to follow it, keep quiet, but don't make disciples along the line. You say the marriage committee is very tough. Go and get wives and husbands. Get wives and husbands for your children. They only encourage them to go and pray, because it's a spiritual business. You make a report, they will go into examination. The committee will investigate the sister, what he or she has seen. You'll be instructed to go and pray. He or she will go and pray. It's not interrogated this year. Then they will now revisit the man. How do you know that this person is your choice? How? After that, go and write it down. That very thing you saw, write it down. If the sister confirms it, she also will go and write. If the sister insists that she doesn't see anything, eventually, the bad brother will go and tell the sister. The sister will report the person to the marriage committee to know whether it is authentic or not. He came to us. You might say, okay, I didn't see anything. Then go and pray. If she returns and say no, if she doesn't see anything, go and pray again. Say, I am not interested. We call the brother. The sister said she has no interest. She didn't see anything. The parents shouldn't hear anything. The parents shouldn't know anything at this point. But we say that if the sister comes and say she likes a particular brother, we will now tell her, hide your vision. Hide it. We will be expecting that brother to come. We have examples that the sisters saw things before the brother. When I interviewed the brother, he explained what he saw. Say, go and pray very well. He came and confirmed it, and they are living happily today. They have never come to settle any feud before me. We say have patience. But everybody is on 100 meter race. Don't drive away your children from the presence of God. But if you conclude that the case is very tough, I will speak if he dresses indecently. You heard about churches where the elders keep on committing immorality with ladies. You want them to be committing immorality with your daughters. That's what we are striving against. If you are not happy, drive them away to where you like. But don't indoctrinate anybody. Because the teaching of the end time, sin shall be multiplied. The man of sin. Maybe next week, by the grace of God, we gather the whole world. All of us cannot stray from the kingdom. Let us pray in Jesus' name. Faith, your Lord. That what you have been, come about, go along. Hallelujah. Okay, hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Okay, hallelujah.
Hallelujah.